let me introduce Jess Thomas, who's going to talk Get Optimising on SEO.
Hi everyone, thanks for coming. So I created this talk because I think when people build their own website or hire somebody to do a website for them, they often think that there's going to be a flurry of organic traffic to their website, but it turns out that the internet is a pretty big place, so it's not that easy for people to find you. So this is just a 10-step checklist of things you can do in order to enable people to find your website. So step one is really basic, but it's just set up your Google Analytics and Google Search Console. So these are just ways, two really great free tools where you can monitor your website traffic. And when you visit those URLs, you'll be guided through a setup process. And one of the last steps is you'll be given some tracking code. So all you need to do is copy and paste this tracking code into your WordPress website. And I personally find a really easy way to do that is just by using the Insert Headers and Footers plugin. Once you've installed and activated this plugin, you can just go to the settings section and under Insert Headers and Footers, just copy your tracking code into the header. So it's really simple, and then from that point going forward, you can start to analyse your website. So step two is setting up your Google My Business profile. This is really important because 46% of Google searches are now for local businesses. So these are search terms such as hairdresser near me or plumber in Glasgow. And in order to appear in the top search results on mobile and on desktop, it's really important you have your Google My Business profile set up. So you do that by visiting this URL or just Google My Business page. And once you start setting this up, it's really important to make sure that your business name, your address, your website details and your phone number are written exactly the same as what they are on your website. So if on your website you've written Road RD, make sure it's written identically on your Google My Business page. And the same for things like UK and United Kingdom. If it's written as a full word, make sure it's written exactly the same on your Google My Business page. And this is really important because it's one of Google's local ranking factors. So make sure you get all of that data really complete and up to date. And once you've done that, it will give you the option to verify your location. And this is really important for having an impact on your ranking and building up that trust with Google. So once you choose to verify your location, they will send a postcard to your address that you've listed on your Google My Business profile. So if your business isn't actually registered at that address, make sure somehow you can get hold of that postcard that they're going to send you. The next step is to add your opening hours, if that's relevant to you, add that onto your profile and encourage people to leave your reviews. So apparently, reviews on your Google My Business page aren't necessarily a direct ranking factor, but it really helps build up trust if people are searching for you. If they can see you've got a better review score than your competitors, they're probably a lot more likely to click through onto your profile. And lastly, make sure you add some pictures to your Google My Business page as well. One thing which is worth noting is that when you take a picture on your phone, or even some cameras as well, it will store the location in the photo's metadata, and apparently Google can actually see that metadata and see where the picture was taken. So if you've taken a picture at your business location, it will scan this, and it's worth adding that geotag if you can. So once you've got your profile set up, you should start submitting your website onto local business directory listings. And this is really important because it shows Google that you're a trustworthy and legitimate business. And by submitting your website and business onto these business listings, you're just building up the backlinks to your website ever so slowly. So it's a really good way initially to show that you're a relevant and trustworthy business. If you were a business based in Glasgow, here are just some examples of local listing sites you might want to be mentioned on. Just really basic, but just to give an example. And one thing to note is when you're submitting your details on these business listing sites, make sure you get your name, address, website and phone number consistent across all of those listing sites as well. So it needs to be the same as it is on your website and as it is on your Google My Business profile. And also don't forget to link from your socials to your website, because these are backlinks as well and it all counts. So step four is make your website faster. So I think there's actually another talk after lunch today about how to improve your website speed, so it's worth going to check that one out. And it's really important that you make your website as fast as possible, because Google likes websites to have a page speed load time of less than 3 seconds. And that's because if your page loads quickly, your users are less likely to bounce off of your page. And it just wants to deliver the best user experience it possibly can to its users. So it is really important. One thing to note is that although they recommend your page speed is under 3 seconds, the UK average page speed load time is actually 5.9 seconds. So if you're bringing it in under that 5.9 seconds, you're going to be much better than the average UK website. So it's a good place to start. So you can measure page speed using these two tools. There are quite a few page speed testing tools you can use, and the free ones particularly tend to pull out slightly different results. So use a couple to give yourself an average and a benchmark. So once you've taken your page speed test, how do you improve those results? These are two really easy to install plugins that you can put on your website. So you've got an image optimising plugin and a caching plugin. There are loads of different versions of this plugin if you have a look, but these are two I'd recommend. And for the sake of spending 5 minutes installing them on your site completely for free, you can really bring your page speed load times down by a good few seconds. And for the sake of improving that user experience, and for a few minutes, it's definitely worth just quickly installing them on your website. So step five is change your permalink structure. So when you first create a WordPress website, it will automatically create a URL structure based around dates, which is quite messy, and it doesn't do anything to help your website from an SEO perspective. So I really recommend going in and changing your permalink structure. You can use the post name structure or a custom structure. I prefer to have the category and then the post name, and this just enables you to get some extra keywords into that URL without having to do anything. So make sure you change your permalink structure. And then step six is install an SEO plugin. So having an SEO plugin on your website is a really simple way of ensuring all of your pages are optimised for the keywords that you want to rank for. So there are loads of different SEO plugins, but my personal favourite is one called Rank Math. It's got some really cool features, it's completely free, it's got some features which are only available with the premium version of Yoast, so I know a lot of people really like Yoast, but this one's my favourite. And if you're currently using Yoast and you want to switch over to Rank Math, it's got a really easy one-click import feature. So all of the data you've installed in Yoast SEO, in a click, you can transfer it all over to Rank Math really easily. So one of the first things I recommend you using Rank Math for is to submit your sitemap to Google Search Console. So your sitemap is literally a map of your website. And once you submit this to Google Search Console, you're basically making it really easy for them to crawl and index your website. So to set this up, you go into Rank Math in WordPress, go to your sitemap settings, and there'll be a big URL at the top, and you can just copy that URL and paste it directly into Search Console. There's just a sitemap section on the left-hand side, and you can just paste it in there. And this step takes about 30 seconds. It's really simple, but it's really important, and it's really going to help you rank going forward. So don't miss this one. So step 8 is then to link your Google Search Console account to Rank Math to one of your keywords. So essentially, this is just a really easy way. You can keep track of all of the keywords, what position you're coming in at on in Google search results, right from inside WordPress itself. So to do that, you just go into Rank Math, click the Search Console tab, and you can authorise your account. There's a big button which you can't miss, and just follow the steps, and then that will enable you to keep track of your keywords in one place and keep track of your positions. So now you're tracking these keywords, how do you start to rank for those top spots in Google? And that leads on to step 9, which is optimising your pages for keywords. So Rank Math makes this really, really easy. And basically, Google has bots which will crawl your website to determine what exactly your website is about, who is that content going to be relevant for, and it will look in certain places on your website. And that's why on-page optimization is really important, because you're making sure you get those keywords in specific places, and using a plugin like Rank Math makes it really easy for you. So these are just some of the places that Google bots will be crawling. So making sure you've got your plugin, you're using it, is really important. So to use Rank Math on-page optimizer, once you have the plugin installed, whenever you go into a page or post, in the top right-hand corner, you'll get a score out of 100. And basically, it works as a traffic light system. So it goes from red, amber to green, and you're constantly trying to push your page up into the green zone. So if you get a score of 85 or above, this will turn green, and then it means your post is ready to publish. So on this page, I'm trying to rank for the focus keyword of Kew Gardens in winter. So you just pop your focus keyword in there, and you should see your score go up ever so slightly. So now I'm at a score of 36 out of 100, but I'm still in the red zone. So it will give you basic steps that you need to follow to bring your page score up. So the first error I need to correct here is the focus keyword does not appear in the SEO title or the meta description. And what you can do to edit this is you just click Edit Snippet, and this is a really great way for you to change how your website is going to appear in search results. So here I've added Kew Gardens in winter to the title, I've added it to the permalink, I've got it in the description, and you can see there's also a colour chart on each of those, in each of those areas as well, so just try and push that up into the green as much as you possibly can. This is going to really impact if people click on your website, to your website from Google search results. So don't just necessarily go stuffing your keywords in there and hoping for the best. Try and make your page sound as enticing as possible so that people want to click on it and read your content. So once you've got those up to the green and you've gone through, corrected all of your errors, you should start to see that the Rank Math bar at the top has turned green, and this means that your post is ready to publish because your page has been optimised for your keyword. It's quite difficult to get a score out of 100 on a full score of 100 on Rank Math. You only get a full score if your content is over 2,500 words long. So if you're not quite up to the 100 mark, then don't worry too much. As long as it's green, that's really great, and you can press go. So once you've got your page optimised, it's really important you keep track of that keyword that you've been optimising that page for. So you can do that within Rank Math inside WordPress, or you can log into Google Search Console and keep track of your position in there. So before this page was optimised, it was ranking in around position 14, and then once I've gone through and done the on-page optimization, it's pushed its position up to, well, it says 4.4, so around 4 or 5 fifth position in Google search results. And that's really important because once you start climbing into those top 5 spots, you're really going to notice your organic traffic will keep increasing. So this is just one page optimized for one keyword. You can see I optimized the page in August, and then from then on, the traffic just continued to increase. And so imagine if you did this for every single page across your website, the results are going to increase by 10 or 20-fold because you're constantly optimising your pages for those keywords. So step 10 is to keep adding content to grow your website traffic. So content still remains the best way to rank your website in search results. So if you keep adding content, you're going to keep adding keywords to your website, and you can optimise those pages and continue growing organic traffic. If you don't really know where to start adding content to your website, I really recommend that you just search for other talks on WordPress TV. People have given some really great talks on content planning, and they've given their slides with templates that you can download, which are really useful. So that's a really good place to start. And if you're still really struggling to add the content to your website, it's really not your thing, there are so many places where you can go now online and basically buy content to add to your site. You can find a content writer on People Per Hour, and even if it's one blog post a month, ideally you want it to be a lot more regular, and even if it's just a 500 word blog post every month, it's better than nothing, and Google can see that you're continuing to keep your website updated and you're keeping that content really fresh. So that was 10 steps you can use to get your website off to its best possible start. So I hope you guys have fun optimising, and thanks for listening.
So, first of all, thank you, Jess. Just as a word, we are going to try and brighten the screen. And apologies, it seems to have started dim and got dimmer. That's pretty much the same, frankly, today. So we'll light another candle or something and wave it at it. But anyway, we'll try and brighten it up for you. Apologies. In the meantime, has anyone any questions for Jess? One right at the back, and then we walk now. Now, we need to get it recorded so you're forever recorded on WordPress TV.
So, when a service is advertised to maintain your SEO as a monthly fee, what is actually involved in that? What are you paying for, and how much of that would you do yourself?
Oh my gosh, it really depends on who you get to do it for you. It really depends on an individual basis, because some people don't really do anything and they'll just pull you a standard report off SEMrush each month and charge you for that. Other people will charge to do all the keyword research, get your content, get content for you onto your website, and start building links up to your website as well. So it just really, really depends on who you use. You've just got to use somebody you trust and make sure that they keep adding the content to your website for you. But it just depends. It's a bit of a... It really depends on the person.
Anybody else? Any questions? And you'll come to see this talk. Can't have answered all the questions.
Just a very quick question. Are the slides available that we can download too, or can
we? Yeah, sure. I'll put them on my site so you can get them in there.
But we'll also make sure on the the WordCamp website, and depending how long it will stay up, but we'll make sure if there aren't the slides themselves, we'll set up links to them, so we'll make sure we get those. But thank you for coming out. Okay.
Just wanted to ask you, you mentioned about buying content. Isn't there a danger of duplicating that content and therefore penalizing for that?
Yes, definitely. So you have to make sure that the content is unique. You really have to, if you want to buy it offline or off an external person, it's just really worth doing your research and using somebody you trust. And yeah, there are lots of dodgy people on places like PeopleProwl as well, where they'll just use automatic website article spinners, and you want to avoid that as much as possible, because you want the content on your site to be really good and engaging. So yeah, it's difficult to find a good content writer. It's not easy, but if you want, I have a few people I can recommend.
Change the title there. Does it override the title that you have manually put in?
Yes, it will. So if you edit, if when you click edit snippet, it will just manually override what's already in there.
And lastly, there's a school of thought that says that if you design your website well and the content is good, Google will analyze it and put up people in the right place and rank it. SEO is maybe not. If a page of the website is designed well, maybe SEO is not all that necessary.
Well, I do agree with you slightly, but if you've not optimised your page and one of your competitors has, then they're much more likely to come above you in the search ranking position. So I think it just depends on what your competitors are really doing. If you've not really got any competitors, then it might not be as important, but you may as well. It's completely free to go away, optimise your pages, do SEO, so you may as well get your website off to its best possible start, in my opinion.
And you do sort of optimise for just one word or two words?
So actually, in RankMath now, you can add up to 5 keywords in that section. So it's difficult to make it green for absolutely every single keyword. But yeah, you can add up to 5 different keywords, and even if you just chose one to start with, once your website is live, you can then keep track of the keywords in Search Console. So if you're thinking, oh, that one seems to be doing a lot better than the one I've put into RankMath, just go in and change the keyword and keep your page and optimise it for that keyword that looks like it's going to start doing a bit better than the other one.
If I decide to move my sitemap, I'm using RankMath, and I say, okay, I don't want to use Google account. I've already set up it with my site, all the configurations with that Google account.
Is it just like the Gmail, Google account you've used? It shouldn't do really. I'd recommend that are you making any changes to your Google My Business profile? Or is that the same?
No, I'm using it for a different company.
Okay.
So there's another company again that I'm creating for, which I have to create my business as well for them.
Okay.
So I don't know can I create my business on more than one business on one Google account?
Yes, you can. Not on your Google My Business page, but just from your bog standard Google account that's got your email and you use to log into Analytics and Search Console. You can have more than one business linked on there. There is a theory which is if you use your business account for your analytics and your Search Console and keep it all the same, that's supposed to help, but I don't think it'll be too much of an issue for if you just add your business to your account.
Back to that.
certainly.
You mentioned keywords, but what about negative keywords? As an example, if you put, if you've got 100 different types of t-shirts, as an example, and you've got 100 different pages, and you put t-shirt on, but you only wanted one style of t-shirt to be shown, I don't think I'm using the right product for this, a negative keyword, you just want t-shirts, but if you wanted a t-shirt on a cup, alright, somebody typed in t-shirt on a cup, you wouldn't want the cup. You'd only want the t-shirt to be shown. How do you get away with not showing? How do you put on to your site the negative keyword? Is that possible?
So, is this saying
for somebody typed in to your Google search t-shirt on a mug, alright, and your keyword for t-shirt?
Yeah.
Is somebody going to go to the t-shirt on a mug?
I mean, it depends on a lot of different factors. It's t-shirt, I'm guessing it's quite hard to rank for the keyword. It really depends on lots of different things. Obviously, you can just make sure that you're using the keyword t-shirt more than on a mug.
The reason I'm asking is my business suit, okay, is I make decorations for cupcakes. So I will put a cupcake topper or cupcake decoration.
Okay.
Somebody looking for cupcakes is going to come up with mine, and I don't do cupcakes.
So, okay, I see what you're saying.
I didn't want to push mine, but
yeah. So if you're optimising your website for that keyword, cupcake decoration, technically, the way Google will crawl your website, it's probably going to know that your business and website is about cupcake decorations and that you're not just selling cupcakes. So if you've got your keyword set up, you've optimised your pages for cupcake decoration, it should be reading it as that. And you might get a few impressions or clicks from people maybe searching for cupcakes. But in general, if you've got the phrase cupcake decoration throughout your site enough, it should be ranking.
Right, and would does Google penalise you then for having similar keywords on all your pages? I've got over 500 products on different pages, okay? They're all the same thing, they just happen to be different, it would be a different thing.
Yeah. Are your descriptions the same or are they different?
They all end, it could be teddy bear, it could be pram, it could be giraffe. Do you know what I mean? They're all decorations for cupcakes and cakes. So,
if you've got the sites like that, are difficult to rank because there's so much duplicate, so many duplicate products and content that's going on there. So if you can make your descriptions for each one unique, then it should be okay. But that's basically what you have to do to make sure that each product is ranking as an individual product.
But one final question, sorry. I paid a company to do citations. Is, in your opinion, should I bring that? I know what I feel, but...
I think if you don't have the time to submit your own website to the business directory, you can definitely pay somebody to do it for you. There's no problem. They should provide you with a spreadsheet that gives you all of the login details, and it should be from trusted, relevant business websites. There's somebody, I think they're called Citations Builder. I think they're based in Glasgow as well, and they can do citations for you. You have to pay. You do have to pay to get the good citations.
Your point number three, when you said you know the address on your website and your business and concern, everything needs to be same. Many a times I come across websites where there is no address, you just have to contact them, write a message, and somebody contacts you. How does this step number three would work in that case? You don't have a physical address listed anywhere on your site.
maybe you have it on the back end, but it is not visible to the traffic.
So if you don't have an address on your website and you can put one on there, I really recommend you put it on there, if you can do that. If you can't, I'm guessing, are you trying to rank for local search terms? Or?
No, globally. So in case, even if my address is local in Glasgow, it is not going to matter for anyone who's in France.
Yeah.
So in that case, how, and since you're talking about foundation and building up right from the beginning, I'm confused how to go about it, suppose. What should I start with?
I think if you can put an address on there, or you can use an address, I would really recommend you put it on your site, because it just helps, makes it look a lot more like a genuine business, really.
It might just keep changing, you know.
Keep changing.
There are websites who do that, who don't have address, who have a contact us page, and then you send a message, and then just start. How does that work? I just want to know.
Well, it's really, for the Google My Business profile, it's just super important if you're wanting to appear in local search results. So if you're not trying to rank locally, it's probably not much of an important factor. So it might not matter as much for your website, but are you wanting to put have you got a Google My Business profile? No. You want to have one.
Architects near me.
Okay.
So in that case, architects near me will not be in Glasgow. It can be anywhere. So for anybody, you know, it is their location which matters and where they are generating that search inquiry from.
Yes.
And even if I have a global presence or, far-reaching presence, and I have members who can serve that community over there, do you understand what I'm trying to say?
Well, you can put multiple locations into your Google My Business listing, so you can have more than one location. I wouldn't really recommend kind of changing your location every week in your address and your Google My Business profile, but yeah, if you've got multiple locations, you can add those into your profile, so I'd recommend doing that. Yeah.
Okay, time for one more, I think. Google's obviously the big player in the search engine market, but what about optimising for other search engines like DuckDuckGo and ones like that? Because I think some people are moving towards them for privacy issues and things like that.
I mean, it's all traffic, so people are using those other search engines, so it is important. Yeah, you can set up like Bing Webmaster Tools and that type of thing, and you will notice people find your website that way. So it is important to set it up. For me, on a personal level, I just tend to focus on Google, so I'm not an expert in those other search engines. But yeah, if you've got the time to put your site on there, get your listings on it, all those other search engines, then why not? Because you might get some extra traffic from it.
Okay, thank you very much indeed, and thank you, Jess. Thank you. Another round of applause.